Hi everyone, my name is Sam and I'm going to be talking for a bit about some of the work I've been doing at the University of Rochester on co-optimization of the camera stack, which includes optics, architecture, and computer vision algorithms. Traditionally, it was the case that cameras capture image data for human use. So as a result, a lot of work has gone into optical design of systems that create accurate image representations that closely mirror what we see in the real world. However, with the prevalence of computer vision as a major technique in a number of application domains, such as robotics, autonomous vehicles, and mobile devices, it's no longer the case that cameras necessarily capture data strictly for human use. Okay, so consider the traditional computer vision pipeline in an embedded vision system. Such a system will be comprised of three main elements, the first being the optical components or lens system, which takes in the actual light from the real world and sends it to the sensor or ISP, or the sensor and ISP, which converts the optical signals into a computer representation. Finally, we have algorithms on the back end, which manipulate the computer representation of the image to get insights. Okay, so first, let's discuss the effect that the lens and the ISP have on image formation. So the lens and ISP in this system will typically or effectively convert real-world images into a digital representation. So given that the typical lens and ISP in a camera system are designed for human use, they're typically designed to create an image representation that as closely mirrors the real world as possible. On the other hand, convolutional neural networks will implicitly use this conventional image representation to train from. However, the representation given by the optical front end might not necessarily be ideal. For example, if we're looking at some sort of image classification task, having more focus on key feature points or having higher contrast may be desirable. So as such, one of the main goals of this research is to explore how redesigning optical front ends can benefit computer vision algorithms. In general, the majority of computer vision research has focused on optimizations purely in the algorithm domain. However, when we consider the computer vision system as a whole, there is room for further optimization by considering co-optimization of the lens and ISP in addition to the algorithm. So a lot of this can be achieved because of the fact that many optical parameters are differentiable with respect to the loss of the convolutional neural network. As such, we can include optical parameters in backpropagation to effectively search through the space of optical front ends to find a stronger image representation. Now, consider this motivational example for quantifying the potential effects that optimizing optics for computer vision can have. Under certain assumptions, such as field constants, an optical system can be modeled by its characteristic point spread function. This point spread function can take the form of a traditional convolutional filter. For this motivational experiment, we consider three optical systems of known quality. PSF0 represents an optical system that has no effect on the image, while the others have their sensor planes slightly mislocated. This has the effect of blurring the output image. In the case of PSF1, the sensor plane is offset by less than in PSF2, so the blur for PSF2 is more serious than it is for PSF1. For this motivational experiment, we also consider an image classification task on a subset of the ImageNet dataset. So we consider two convolutional neural nets as our vision algorithms. Inception V3 is considered as a baseline that's close to state of the art, while MobileNet is considered for its performance and energy efficiency, which we measure in MAC operations compared to Inception V3. These models are trained initially on unaltered versions of the ImageNet data. We then test our algorithms on images that have been passed through our optical models. So if we look at this first red bar, we can see that when there's no PSF in the optical system, Inception V3 classifies 95% of the test images correctly, while MobileNet classifies roughly 80% correctly. However, when we model the test images through the first optical system, we can see that both CNNs drop in accuracy. And then this drop in accuracy continues for PSF2 as well. So overall, we see a significant drop in accuracy when we start considering less optimal optical systems. In the case of Inception V3, this drop in accuracy amounts to about 10%, while it amounts to up to 50% for MobileNet. So this shows that as the lens deviates farther from ideal, the accuracy drop becomes worse and worse. And additionally, Inception V3's drop in accuracy is lower. This is likely because the more complex neural net is more robust to these types of optical changes. So overall, this leads us to the conclusion that when we're deploying a vision system, not considering the effect of optics can significantly affect the overall system performance, especially for neural nets with fewer parameters. Now, if we're aware that the lens and sensor can introduce a significant amount of error One of the potential solutions we can use to account for algorithm error is by training our algorithms on image data that's also been forward modeled through the optical system. So in order to replicate that in this experiment, we can convolve our training set with the lens PSF and then rerun our tests on data that's been convolved with the same PSF. So overall, this should lead to an increase in accuracy compared to the baseline that we set earlier. Okay, so here the red and green bars are the same bars from the previous experiment, and the yellow bars represent what happens when we train Inception V3 on the same PSF, and the blue bar represents what happens when we train MobileNet on the same PSF. So overall, we can see that the algorithm accuracy improves. However, we can still see that algorithms trained on weaker optical systems are not able to recoup all of the accuracy just through optics-aware training. So this suggests that some optical systems are just intrinsically easier to work with. So yeah, as we can see now, the drop for Inception V3 is roughly 10%, but it's now only about 30% for MobileNet. However, we can see that accuracy still decreases for weaker PSFs. And just as a bit of a side note and a motivational reason for the third motivational experiment that we have, you can see that MobileNet trained on PSF 0 is just as accurate as Inception V3 trained on PSF 2, which suggests that we can save about 20 times the compute by having a more effective optical front end, so we don't have to have all this extra compute power in order to combat the weaker optics. So motivated by that previous point that a weaker algorithm can outperform a stronger algorithm if it has a better image representation to use, we introduce a third convolutional neural net with about 200,000 parameters and about 3 times fewer MAC operations than MobileNet. And we compare it on a stronger optical system than with, or we compare it on a stronger optical system to Inception V3 and MobileNet on a weaker optical system. Here, we consider our strong optical system to be PSF1 from the previous experiment, and our weak optical system to be PSF2 from the previous experiment as well. In our results, we see that the simple convolutional neural net on the stronger optics is able to outperform MobileNet, but not Inception V3. So this overall suggests that there is this trade-off between optics and compute in the algorithm domain that can lead to differing results in accuracy. So we've shown that we're able to achieve 3 times compute savings by having better optics just by being able to use a weaker neural net as a result, and that it takes approximately 70 times more operations to actually overcome these weaker optics, as we can see with Inception V3. In addition to considering the effect of optics, many embedded vision domains operate under highly resource-constrained situations where things such as energy efficiency and latency play an important role in the overall performance of the system. So recent work in our lab is able to incorporate energy and latency budgets into the convolutional neural net training performance, which allows us for performance guarantees on both energy and latency on CNN inference, given certain hardware constraints. So as such, we can design an effective co-design system that incorporates architecture, optics, and algorithmic design parameters, where we're given image data, and then we can convolve it with the point spread function of the optical system, simulate the sensor, and send that to the convolutional neural net, where we can get task-specific loss. From that point, we can backpropagate that task-specific loss across the convolutional neural net parameters, as well as optical parameters and hardware parameters, thus being able to formulate our co-design problem as an optimization over optics, hardware, and algorithmic parameters. Formally, this co-training can be expressed as an argmin over those 3 sets of parameters on the loss of the task, such that our latency of the hardware is lower than some sort of latency budget, and that our energy with respect to the hardware and CNN weights is lower than our energy budget. Now, this co-design process has multiple applications based off of 2 main types of parameters that we're able to optimize over. So various parameters such as lens shape, number of MAC units, and total memory size are design time parameters. In this case, we can use our co-training framework to design an efficient domain-specific camera where these parameters are allowed to vary. However, in a lot of cases, there's another set of parameters such as network weights, focal distance, lens aperture, memory partition, and other things that we refer to as runtime parameters. These parameters can be incorporated into the co-training framework to have such a domain-specific camera automatically tune itself. So as future work in vision, we're trying to implement this idea as a domain-specific camera with parameter storage to store configurations for other vision tasks, By doing so, we'll design cameras that have potential applications to a number of application domains, such as robotics and autonomous vehicles and mobile computer vision, where we have several key vision tasks to execute continuously, and being able to do so efficiently has enormous potential benefits.